Rao, my boy, let me show you how to use that new bow of yours. You will now learn to use your bow. While holding the bow, you can target enemies on the ground using the right analog stick, as you do with your sword. Press the button assigned to an enemy to fire an arrow as an attack. This is okay, but is slow, limits your range, and may require more than one shot to kill an enemy. To further your range, hit enemies up above and perhaps kill with a single arrow, but you must aim carefully. Hold down the L1 button and maneuver the directional stick to aim freely. Try it now. When you are aiming this way, you can target an enemy or object. When targeted, an X icon will appear above the enemy or object. You would then press the X button to fire your arrow. Hold L1 and aim the directional stick to target a gong, then press the X button to fire your arrow. When you've hit both gongs, we will continue. Try it now. Hold L1 and aim the directional stick to target a gong. Then press good enough for shooting gongs. Shooting enemies is another matter. When you target an enemy, the X icon will flash. This means you are aiming for the enemy's body and will need a few arrows to take your enemy down. Let's try shooting the body of the dummy. Hold down the L1 button, aim for the dummy, and when the X icon flashes, fill the dummy with some arrows. Try it now. Useful. But it is best to take an enemy down with one arrow when you can. To do this, target the enemy, then carefully aim up with the directional stick until the X icon is solid. When the X icon is solid, press the X button to fire your arrow. Try it now. Your aim is true! And that is all I will teach you here today. There are spare arrows out here, so you may practice for as long as you like. By the gods, those birds are a racket! Remember, flocks of birds may be good for distracting enemies. Try disturbing a flock of birds to get the enemy's attention, then sneak up from behind for an easy kill. Now, back to the job. Rao, always be on the lookout for enemies wearing armor. They are a greater threat and impervious to arrows.
In combat are spreading far, young man. I am looking to hire someone such as you, someone looking for adventure, someone who does not shy away from a challenge. There is a forest north of here you may have heard of called Hayadoko. It has a reputation for being a dangerous place to pass through. People enter it, but few people leave. At the center of this place lays an ancient tomb, hidden undisturbed for millennia, guarded by the forces within those woods. I have no interest in treasure, as I am a wealthy man and can pay you handsomely for your trouble. I am, however, interested in a scroll that is said to be in the tomb. This parchment has no value to the common man. It is only a record of my ancestry, written in an ancient tongue. Rao, I am an old man, trying to understand the breadth of my line. Let us say that this document will allow my family to re-establish its proper place in society. If you procure me this scroll, I will make you a very wealthy man.
That creepy old man needs to stop staring at me, or I'm gonna break a bottle over his head.
My master left early the next day and arrived at the Heiadoko Forest as the sun began to rise. Baomusu had reacted strangely to this opportunity, saying he did not trust the old man, referring to him as Dark One. He warned Rao not to aid him, as he sensed evil. But my master was young and stubborn. The old man had promised him gold, and its luster coaxed him on.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Imo!
Thank you.
At any time, only 6 people have the mark of Kree, each one holding a line from the spell within its designs. 6 families are cursed with this mark, the firstborn in each carrying part of the spell until the day they die. In death, the mark is then passed along to the next born in the family line. This way, the mark is never lost, and the families are cursed for all eternity.
Thank you.
Fearing for their lives, the line of Usu fled Tongatu, leaving behind their lands and possessions. After many moons of traveling, they came to a great forest and sought shelter within its grounds. As they feared, the mark returned to the next born, identical in shape and color as the one that Ruutu had bore. Fearing the same would happen to this child as had happened to Ruutu, the line of Usu swore none would see this mark again. It would remain hidden and no one would ever leave the forest. I am Sumbu Usu, last of my family line, and bearer of the mark of Kree. To break the curse, we agreed to never bear children. To end this legacy through the ending of our family line, this tomb is guarded with purpose. If you find yourself reading my words, take heed. Later that day, as agreed, the old man met my master at the entrance to the forest. He now wore official-looking robes and was flanked by bodyguards. His personality also seemed to have changed. He now seemed less feeble, more demanding, less in need. Rao handed over the scroll and received his payment, the parting words from the old man chilling him to the bone.
You are a rich man, barbarian. When your day comes, you too can now afford such a tomb.
My master traveled home slowly. The gold wore heavy on his heart. The prospect of its riches failed to excite him. This latest enterprise had troubled him deeply. What was this mark that cursed its owner? Why was it hidden away in such an impenetrable manner? What exactly was on the parchment he had stolen for the old man? For many days, he wandered before returning home, deciding to keep this latest adventure from Baomusu, lest he disapprove.
Rao, that old lady says she knows the future.
Rao, beware the Kosai. My spirits tell me that they wish you harm. It was they who...
Norvig.
Rao, beware the Kosai. My spirits tell me that they wish you harm.
Rao, you look troubled. Allow me to read your fortune, Blissett. Give me your hand. You have just returned from a journey. You entered the Hayadoko Forest and lived to tell. Few have done this. Young man, you have been tricked. The gold you were recently given is hexed. These coins bear the mark of the Kusai. Avoid this sign. It is evil. Where did you get such coins? I cannot see the one who paid you. He has the ability to hide from my vision. Be careful, Rao. The giver of these coins has great power. You have help, though. You have a familiar. The bird called Kuso. Good. He is your spirit guide sent from the gods to watch over you. Use him and trust his vision. Listen to me carefully, boy. You have importance in this world, that much is clear. You are a tool of the gods, for they watch your moves with interest. You need to leave as soon as possible and travel to the mountains north of here. There is a fortress there called Baitaku. Seek out an ancient tree and eat its fruit. The fruit that grows on this tree has great power, and when eaten will show you your destiny, for this tree is an oracle. Go there now. But remember, barbarian, this is an evil place. The tree is all that is good there.